not inconsiderable fortune in the tens of thousands of pounds, goes to his only child, Susan Hollister.
Think of Daddy!
Yes, darling. But I'm Inspector.
Yes, Mrs. Hollister.
If Susan should happen to die or anything, then where would the money go?
In that event, of course, the money would all revert to you.
I see. Oh, of course, it was just a hypothetical question.
Oh, of course, Mavis, I quite understand that. But don't worry about me. I'm very young and terribly healthy, so I'm certain I shan't die for years and years.
I'm sure of it, my dear, and just to be certain, I shall watch over you like a mother hen every moment you're living here under my roof.
Your roof?
Just a figure of speech, but if anything has happened to Edgar, heaven forbid, of course, this will be my roof she's under.
Well, I guess that's true enough.
I say, Mavis, even if this house should become your own, you'd continue to let me live on.
Live on?
Live on here as your house guest, I mean.
Oh, well, yes, of course. Susan, this is your home where you were born and raised, and here you shall live as long as I like. Oh, that is, as long as you like. there's no point in interrupting Marty when she's preparing lunch. Hello? Oh, yes, just a moment. It's that constable. He wishes to speak to you.
Probably has a report on the target pistol. Crandall here! What? But are you quite sure? Yes. See. Rory Constable, thank you. Well, it's the strangest thing.
What is it, Inspector? Did something odd turn up in ballistics or wherever he was taking that pistol?
Not quite. You see, he never took the pistol to ballistics.
But I'm certain that's where he intended to take it.
And he had. But you see, he suddenly discovered there was nothing ballistics could test for him.
I'm afraid I don't understand.
Well, it's the weirdest thing. I mean, after all, it was a target pistol, so I really don't understand it myself.
Understand what, Inspector?
The pistol was loaded with blank cartridges.
Please note that smoking is prohibited in our building. Thank you.